next on Hollywood Clowning Black Women.
I'd just like to take a moment to thank my staff. I have the best staff on the planet, and I think I really did a good job putting them together. And all the things that happen are because of them. They're the wind beneath my wings. Actually, I only made one major mistake in my hiring. I wanted my sister to help because she knows my comedy sensibilities, and she's my fraternal twin sister. We're from Cleveland, obviously. She lives in Alabama right now. And I made her my head writer. That probably wasn't a great decision, and I changed that. Let me show you some footage from The Office. Check this out.
All right, damn it. What's going on? I hope y'all got some funny stuff. Because if it don't make Marcinio laugh, it ain't going to make Arsenio laugh. And if it don't make Arsenio laugh, somebody going to get their ass beat. All right. Now, who's first? Who in the hell is Lindsay Lohan?
That actually says Lindsay Lohan.
Lindsay Lohan? Didn't I tell your ass that we ain't bring Lindsay Lohan up in the writer's room?
I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
Hey, you get in that kitchen and you ice that ass. Get on up out of here. Go. I'm gonna give you 5 seconds head start. You feeling froggy? Then jump. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Pig knuckles smothered in chitlins is ready. I made it with a lot of season salt.
I'm sorry, but I'm a vegetarian.
Well, so is this pig. Now, you got two choices. Either you put that food in your mouth, or I put my foot in your ass.
I think it tastes great. Good stuff, right?
Mike, get over here and scratch my back. No. Up under the shirt. Undo my bra. Get in there. I'm scratching like a bitch. Dig your nails in there a little bit digger. Yeah, I got elephant skin. Don't worry, go. Make me wanna go to church.
Care.
Shut up, Phil. Just think of it as backup hair, because God took yours away.
Marcinia, who is that man?
Oh, that's my boyfriend. They fumigating his house right now, so he gonna sit with us today. His name is Kool-Aid. I call him that because he busts through this every night.
Oh, yeah.
My paternal twin sister, Marcinia. I can't believe my future brother-in-law will be named Kool-Aid. That's confusing for me.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Hollywood Clowning Black Women. Now, the Arsenio Hall show took it upon itself to make a woman that was supposed to be his twin be very fat, with a gray wig on, sexually promiscuous with a low-down, dirty, no-good black man who's probably leeching off of her. She's very violent, sexually suggestive to all the white men. Rude, loud. And this is a skit that was, I'm sure, seen by millions before I even saw it. So the next question is, let's see if any of the 100,000 black men against Tommy Sotomayor become 100,000 black men against Arsenio Hall, or maybe Fox, or whoever airs the Arsenio Hall show. My question is, black women, why are you constantly being portrayed as this? Is it that there's an attack on you, or is it that you do this? Let's be frank right now. Is Arsenio making up the stereotype of black women? Did you not grow up with an old woman who was like this? Did you not know that old lady? Because every comedian's made that joke about that nosy old lady who sits on the porch in her nightgown. Because this woman showed up to her job in a nightgown. Remember that. Although Arsenio can keep himself in shape, his twin sister could not. Although Arsenio can keep his hair and everything looking at least as if he's in his 40s, his twin sister could not. Although Arsenio can articulate himself, his black twin sister could not. And of course, we know that is not his twin sister. But the point is, what gave him the courage to portray black women this way? What gave the white people to give him the okay to portray black women this way? And what gives you people who claim that I'm such a bad dude the right to go after someone as small as me when you have a whole industry that would do more to black people than I ever have? When, as a matter of fact, I've freed more people from the matrix than they ever will. And than you ever could. Hollywood does what it wants. And none of you Negroes have the balls, the gall, or the audacity to stand up and say a word. And what pisses you off more than anything is that I do. And what pisses you off more than that is the fact that the more people mess with me, the more it fuels me to go and do what I'm supposed to be doing on this earth. Now, you hate me because you haven't found your calling. When your calling is to mess with me, it's not a calling. This woman, this black woman, took this acting job. Did you notice that every time a woman is rude, disgusting, foul mouthed, she is a dark skinned woman? They would have never let a half breed portray this character. Why is that? But then we would have never let a half breed portray this character. If it had been all black network, the black folks would have hired a dark skinned black woman to play this role. Why? Can you imagine the furor that would have came down had a white man done this? Oh, white men. See how she made the pig feet covered in chitlins? You see how they made the black man be a simp and have to sit there and say, this is good stuff. See how, as the black woman was eating her way into a grave, the white woman says, I am a vegetarian. See how the black woman walks around with this stupid hair hat on, the white woman has her natural hair. See, you claim I try to make black women look bad and I put white women on a pedestal. No, I just call out what I see. Now, I said nothing in this video that was not in their video. I said nothing in this video that was not portrayed by this Arsenio Hall video. I didn't cuss. I didn't call you whores. I didn't call you bitches. I didn't call you anything. I just let you see how Hollywood clowns you on a everyday basis. It's not Hollywood clowning you. It's you clowning you. Because if black women had decided they didn't want to take this job, they would have never had a black woman in order to sit in front of the world and do this. Will anybody find out who this character is, who the woman who played this is? Will they call her a coon? Will any of those clowns stalk her? Let's see if it happens. Will any of those clowns take pictures of her daughter and her family and put them out on the internet? Will any of those people put out her information so we can stalk her? Because, of course, what she's doing is hurting the black community. Isn't she not? Well, let's see. If the people go after her the way they went after me with such zest, such zeal, such fervor, let's see if it happens. But I doubt it will. Because, see, Negroes feel like they can touch me, and that's the only thing Negroes are good at doing. They're programmed to destroy each other and not touch the people who are actually causing them harm. So go on with your little crusade. I'll go on with mine. We'll see who falls on the right side of history. I'm Tommy Sotomayor. It's another episode of Hollywood Clowning Black Women.
As I walk the streets of Hollywood Boulevard, big and hard it was for those who starred in the movies portraying the roles of butlers and maids, slaves and hoes. Many intelligent black men seem to look uncivilized when on the screen. Like I guess I figure you to play some jigaboo on the plantation. What else can a nigga do? And black women in this profession, after playing a lawyer, out of the question. For what they played Aunt Jemima is the perfect term, even if now she got a perm. So let's make our own movies like Spike Lee, cause the roles being offered don't strike me as nothing that the black man could use to earn. Burn Hollywood, burn.